everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Lulu, for those of you who don't already know. So I know I haven't filmed in forever, it has literally been ages, but I've had so much going on, so much has changed, all for good, all positives, thank God, glory be to God. So I'm gonna do a like life update for you guys, because I know like if you follow me on Snapchat or Instagram, you probably have an idea of what's going on, but if you don't, and you're just a loyal YouTube subscriber, you guys deserve all the tea too, so I'm gonna do a life update. But that's for another day. Today is an unboxing video and I'm super, super excited. So I received this, again, if you follow me on my socials, I showed you guys the box when I got it from YSL Beauty. I actually got it from the good people of Glam Brand Agency. They sent me this and there's a lot of goodies inside, guys. But if you are a true YSL fan, beauty fan, you kind of have an idea by what the box is of what's inside, but I haven't shown anybody what's inside, so if you're excited and you're interested to see what I got, then let's keep watching. Okay, so for the moment we've all been waiting for, this is what's in the box. The entire collection of the slim mattes from YSL. So basically these are slim, so you know how like lipstick can be a bit bulky in your bag? These are slim. Oh, I don't want to show you the colors yet, but I'll show you this one. And when you twist it like this, it just comes up like this. The nice sharp edge. The packaging is so classy, so chic. And like, they're all matte. And I generally like matte stuff, because then I can either leave it matte or I can gloss it up. So this is actually perfect for me. The entire collection has 16 shades. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going out tonight. So I've done my face pretty neutral, neutral eyeshadows, like no color or anything, so that all of these could be an option for me. And I think I'm wearing either white or black, so it doesn't even matter. I'm gonna try on a few shades so that you can see like what the color payoff is like and just consistencies and stuff like that. And I just love playing with things like this. So you guys, let's just have some fun. Okay, so the only con I have of these is that there's no like name of the colors at the bottom, they're just numbers, which I guess might be easier for some people, but I like to remember like makeup names and I just like the names that they give them, so generally I get excited for that. So that's the only con, there are no like names of the colors, but I'm gonna go through all the colors anyway. So this is color one. I would say this is like a nice rouge. So I would say this is like a nice rougey red kind of color. It's not too deep, still a bit bright, which is really pretty. Color two is a little more interesting. This is like an orange. I'll post a picture here of when I wore something similar, because I've gotten some of these colors from when I went to the Jordan Woods Grey Goose launch, which you guys obviously, not launch, but the welcome party for when Jordan Woods was around. We got a few of these in our goodie bags and one of them was number two. So I'm gonna post a picture here of when I wore the number two color with my blonde hair. It was so nice. I got so many compliments when I wore this color. Color three is like a purple. This is very interesting. This usually isn't a shade that I would wear, so maybe I'll try this shade on. I probably am going to try on the shades I wouldn't wear on a normal day just to see what they look like on, but this purple is very interesting because you usually just get like pinks and stuff, so this is a little bit fun. This is color three. Okay, color four is sort of like a mesh between a red and a purple, so it's quite burgundy-ish, which is interesting. It's quite, I would still say it reminds me of Deborah by NARS, which is like a brown, but not quite brown. It's like a brownish burgundy, but more on the red side. Ooh, this is interesting. This is a really nice color. This reminds me of Coffee from Maybelline. If you are a Maybelline fan or a Maybelline girl, big like me, you would know they're like lipstick colors. It reminds me of Coffee. That's a very interesting dupe for this. So it's brown. This is very nice. I think I'm gonna try this one on as well. This, it skips a number and just jumps straight to color seven. So this is color seven. This is more of a softer pink, which is probably what I would wear. This would be my idea of a bold pink, because I wear pretty, actually no, I think this would come on pretty nude on as well. I just like how sharp they are. Like, I love lipsticks that have a sharp edge, because you can almost kind of use it as a lip liner, which is pretty cool. Okay, no, this is a sharp pink. So this is like a hot pink. This is the color eight. This is like a very sharp, almost like a hot pink. Ooh, this looks so, this is like a very sexy color, in my opinion. This is like a very, sorry, let it focus. yeah, like it's a soft, this I would call a soft red. This is not quite as brown as Deborah, but oh, and it's just such a sharp color payoff. Look, I literally just touched my hand and look what's come out. Like, oh, can't wait to try some of these on for you guys. I just want to show you all the colors first and then we'll play around with it on my skin. Okay, color 10. This reminds me of like Max Ruby Woo. Sorry, I'm trying to give you guys like a bit of, because I know like looking on camera doesn't always give the right like color, so I'm trying to give you guys other brand descriptions so you may have tried or seen that color to give you a better idea of what the color is. This I would definitely say is similar to a Max Ruby Woo, which is also matte, but I used to find that formula too drying, so I never really used the Ruby Woo, but these formulas are so moisturizing that actually this will probably now become my holy grail red, to be honest. Okay, this one is like Max Teddy. This is more of a very similar to the first color, actually, a very neutral pink. Sorry, not the first color, the seventh color. So I just want to put those side by side so you can compare color 7 with color 11. For those of you who like nudie kind of looks, you can have a better idea. Like, there isn't really much difference, but you can just tell that one has a slightly stronger pink undertone than the other. But I love the variety, like, because everyone's lips are a different shade of pink. Like, this is probably more me than this, and I like that I have the option of picking, so I can darken this with some lip liner if I want to, or I can just go like with this. And as you can tell, I'm kind of giving this my thumbs up. Okay, color 12 is very similar to color 11. So I think in this collection, they've just given us like options for nudes, and there are a lot of nudes and a lot of reds. So I think they've just given us like a lot of options so you can really like find your shade, which I think is what lipstick is all about. Like, you should be able to find your shade and then find shades to play with alongside your shade. Ooh, this color 13 reminds me of a medley between the orange I showed you before and a red. So it's not quite as bright. It's a little bit more of like a deeper undertone, but it's still quite orange. So this is pretty cool too, actually, I'm not gonna lie. I usually only wear like nudes or browns, so this collection is great for me because it's mostly nudes and browns, but I've gone off red. I don't know why I've gone off red, but I'm gonna try red again. I'm gonna try red in this video, and you guys can tell me what you think I look like with red lipstick, because I'm so nervous. This is the pink that I think it's just one step down from the hot pink. So if you don't do hot, hot, hot pink, and you can do like hot-ish pink, I would say this is like hot-ish pink. One is the hot pink and one is the one I've just shown you. So as you can see, they're very, very similar, but there's just an ever so slight difference for people who can't go quite the whole way. Okay, next up we have another red, which is deeper than the Ruby Woo dupe I talked about, but not quite like burgundy, not quite ox blood. Well, maybe I'll call this ox blood, I don't know. It's just like a deeper red. So this is probably more of like a date night red, whereas the other one is probably more of a daytime red. Like, I don't know, I just feel like dark lips are more for nighttime and then bright lips are for daytime, but everybody's different and you can wear whatever you want because you're a woman or a man, doing whatever you like. So this is the second to last one. This is color 16, another pink. They've given me lots of pink in this, so I'm gonna like be playing with these. I need to get some lip liners to match. I think that's one thing I love about Kylie Jenner's like lip thing, that they come with lip liners, because that sort of just helps your lipstick stay a lot better throughout the day. So I need to go like lip liner shopping. I'm probably gonna just do drugstore like lip liners, because there's like so many of these. I'm not buying like $12 lip liners for this. And it's not all the time I like to just use browns, so. Okay, and for the last one, this is color 17. This is actually the one that is my shade, because I have this already and I'm almost out. So shout out to you guys for giving me another one. I love, love, this is the color you see me in all the time. It's my everyday shade. Sometimes I add the gloss, sometimes I do not. Yeah, and this is color 17. It's just a very nice like baby pink. Okay, so what I've done is I was initially gonna do 4, but I love so many of these that I just picked more than 4. I now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shades that I'm gonna try on for you guys. So you can just see what they look like on. I can show you a little bit about the texture and the consistency and stuff like that, because that's really the true tell of lipstick. It's not just how it looks and the packaging, but I will say the packaging is bomb. The precision on this is insane because of the sharp tip. Oh my god. It's so like moisturizing.
Boyfriend, we no like to spend. She get it, boyfriend. He too dey kaku. Ah, she get it, boyfriend. Oh my, she has
done. For this first one, I have to say the consistency is really creamy. Like I can actually like pucker my lips, and it doesn't feel like they're smacking together. Especially for something that's matte. Usually matte lipsticks dry your lips out, and I must admit that this does not. And so like a massive thumbs up. And I'm a bit skeptical about red, but I feel like I picked a good color. I feel like a bit of a geisha. Hey. So let's try on the next one. Okay guys, so that is the end of my Slim Matte review from YSL. Again, all positive, all love. Like, these colors are very pigmented. I love the shade options. They are really, really moisturizing, and they're really small, so they fit like in your bag so easily. Like, I feel like this packaging is just sleek and it just looks very like cool. So it's just nice to like hold and stuff like that. But all in all, I actually just think the product is worth it. Like, it's really, really good. I'll put more information about everything down below, and I'll also have a little mini video out up on my Instagram with details in the caption, so make sure you guys check that out and check this out as well, like down below. Don't forget and don't miss out, so you can make sure you can get these. Thanks so much for watching. I will be doing more unboxing videos. I had so much fun doing this because obviously it was like my first time trying it on camera, so these are natural like real reactions and like real excitement about the product. Yeah, and I just love doing stuff like this, so I will try and do much, 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 much more if I can. And I will just see you guys in my next video. Oh, my next video is actually another unboxing video, but something a little bit techie. So just make sure you stay tuned for that, and I will see you guys in my next one. Thanks for riding with me through all my absences. And before you go, if you've hit this point, you're a real one, and make sure you hit the subscribe button. Bye!